everybody, I am back with another video, and believe it or not, I have more pickups for the month of December. I know it sounds absolutely absurd that I would have gotten more games than I'd already gotten that month, but I got this stuff for really cheap, like literally next to nothing, and some of it was actually gifts that I forgot to include in my Christmas video, because actually the gift to the right there, that red box you see, my dad actually forgot to give me. He kind of found it in one of the closets around the house. He's like, oh, Rusty, I completely forgot about this. Or I guess Santa forgot about it, you know, because he exists. So, but yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and get right into that and explain, you know, that piece of amazingness right there. And then I also picked up some games here from Half Price Books. And I also went around with Ben, CC10 Gaming. He came down to Columbus and visited me. And we just found some awesome stuff. Went to a few different stores and made it on some nice deals there. And I also, Best Buy was having some unbelievable deals this holiday season. And I was able to get a collector's edition for $9.50, free shipping. And once you see what that is, it's absurd that I paid that much. I should have paid much more for that because it's an amazing collector's edition. But I'm going to go ahead and get started here, guys. So,
as always,
Calvin... Oh, well, he doesn't want to, but he's like sitting here. Now he's trying to run away. He's scared. But he's sitting on my lap here. But the first thing we have here is an Atari Flashback 3. Now, there are three models of this, obviously. There may be more. I don't believe there is, though. This thing, if you can see this little sticker up here, it says $40. But my dad actually got it on sale for $30, which is crazy because if you go on eBay... These things are selling from anywhere to $60 to like $100. And the first two models are completely like out of print. You can't find them anywhere really except on eBay and Amazon. And if you're going to get them on those two places, you're going to be paying upwards of $100 to $200. I mean, it's like ridiculous how much these have just like skyrocketed in value. I don't know why, because I mean, they're just like basically plug and plays with this game. This has 60 Atari games on it, which is fantastic. Some really nice classics on here. And it's a really nice way to just be able to plug this in and not have to worry about, you know, cleaning your carts and just constantly, you know, switching out games because all of them, with the click of a button, are all available right there. So that was really cool. I really like the back of this, too. It's almost like, you know, an actual console box like the N64, how they used to have the game pictures on there. But you can see here all around the outside there, there's pictures of each of the games that are included. So that's really, really cool. And for $30, not a bad price at all. I'm very psyched to have gotten that. Next, we'll go into, I'll get the collector's edition here. Like I said, guys, $9.50 free shipping. Unbelievable deal. And that is the BioShock 2 collector's edition. I'm by no means going to open this up for you guys because there are like 3 gajillion unboxings here on YouTube. But once, just please guys, pause the video or after the video, look up an unboxing. Preferably, I'm going to plug FinGamer and TV and Lust, of course, my two favorite channels. Both of them did unboxings for it, so check out theirs. But just some unbelievable stuff included in here. I actually played through this game in 2 sittings. Absolutely loved it. Loved it more than I did BioShock 1. I know a lot of people thought it was just more of the same, but to me, I liked it more, and I cannot wait to see what BioShock Infinite has in store for us later this year. But once you guys see the unboxing, you will see that it should have been like a criminal felony to have paid $9.50 for this with free shipping. So thank you, BestBuy.com, for doing that, putting that deal up. But this is a fantastic special edition. And if you can't get the special edition and you haven't played BioShock 2 yet, please get the game. It is
I'm
going to
go through the stuff that I got at Half Price Books first because I want to go through the stuff that I got with Ben last because there's some really cool stuff in that
little bundle there. But I'm going to go ahead and get started here. The first PSP game that I got, I think I got this for $3, Untold Legends Brotherhood of the Blade. Really a game that I've been wanting for quite some time. I believe it was a launch title for the PSP, but there are 4 playable characters. It's an action RPG kind of dungeon crawler kind of game, and it just looked really fun. And I know there's a second one. The name isn't coming to mind immediately, but I've been wanting to play this for a long time, so I'm happy to have gotten this for $3. Another RPG
that I've not really heard much about, but it looked interesting, and it's another hack and slash action RPG, and that is Warriors of the Lost Empire. It also looks like just kind of a dungeon crawler hack and slash RPG. I love those types of games, so I figured for $3, I couldn't go wrong. Looks like there's a lot of different playable classes and characters, a lot of different skills and upgrades in this game, and it looks like a lot of fun, so if you guys have played that one, let me know, but for $3, I couldn't go wrong with that. I love Hot Shots Golf. Hot Shots Golf 3 and 4 on the PlayStation 2 are some of my favorite sports games of all time, and then Hot Shots Golf Open Tee 1 and 2 for the PSP, I love as well. So when I saw this there, I had to get it. It is the first Hot Shots Golf game, in absolutely perfect condition, no scratches or scuffs on the disc, and the manual's in there and everything. It's awesome. And I got this for $1, but since they were having a 20% off sale, I ended up getting it for 80 cents. So I felt like I was at a garage sale picking this up for $1, which is really, really cool. I'm happy to have gotten that. The next game is the Simpsons game, an Xbox 360 game that I'm really enjoying. I've put about 3 or 4 hours in. It's really cool. You know, you can play as all the family members with the exception of Maggie. And it's kind of like this open hub world that you can just kind of go around Springfield and then, you know, collecting lots of little, like, goodies and stuff like that. But you can also, obviously, go to your next mission episode that's located in different spots around the city. But what's really cool about this game is that there are actual cutscenes that look like the cartoon. My sister came downstairs and thought I was watching The Simpsons, and then I picked up my Xbox controller and started playing, and she had no idea what was going on. But it's really cool because the original voice actors of the TV series actually do the voices for the game. So it's really cool. They're not just some, you know, knockoff people just randomly saying stuff from The Simpsons. It is actually The Simpsons, and there's over 45 minutes of recorded footage for cutscenes in this game. Really cool stuff. And it's a great co-op game. It reminds me of the Lego games especially because it's just, you know, pop in, pop out co-op whenever you want. So if you haven't played The Simpsons game, definitely give this a try. I think I paid $7 for this, so not a bad deal at all. And then the final game here is a series that I've yet to get into, really. I have the second one, and I don't know, I put a few hours into it, and I just couldn't get into it, but I want to go back to it in the summer, and then I want to move on to the third one, and that is Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. I believe Snake Eater is coming out in the 3DS as well, so you know, I may just end up playing the second one, getting the third one on the 3DS. But for, how much did I pay for this? I think $3 I paid for this. And this is in perfect condition. So that was really cool. But I want to get into these because I love Splinter Cell. And I love Hitman, if you guys have ever played the Hitman games. And this is kind of like those games in a blender. So I don't know what it is that I'm just not completely gripped by this game. But I want to get back into Sons of Liberty, the second one. And hopefully it can really kind of, you know, grab me into the Metal Gear atmosphere, and Kojima can hook me because I want to get into these games.
Like I said, guys, I went around to several stores with my friend Ben, CC10 Gaming here on YouTube,
and the first thing I picked up here was just the power cable for the Dreamcast because my cousin actually didn't have the power cable, and I paid $3 for this, not bad at all. So that was really cool. And they also included in here, I don't know if you guys can see that, it's like a little Mario $20 bill, and then on the back it has like all of the store's information. So that's really cool. And then I picked up at GameStop, of course they were having their buy two get one free sale over the holidays, and I couldn't pass that up. And my Wii collection is pathetic at the moment. And there are so many great games to be had on the Wii that I just haven't had a chance to play. And I picked up three that you know, aren't by no means AAA titles that everyone's running out, you know, purchasing a Wii to play these games, but they're games that I have always had an interest in playing. And the first one being No More Heroes. Just a really unique looking art style in this game, and it almost looks like the main protagonist of the game has a lightsaber. I'm not really sure what the heck he has, but it looks really, really cool. I've heard great things about it. It reminds me of just an anime, to be honest. Like, you're just playing an anime. Just the graphics and art style look really, really cool, and it looks like just a really interesting game. So if you've played No More Heroes or No More Heroes 2, let me know what you guys think about the series. The next game we have is a Sega title. I haven't heard a whole lot about it on the Wii, but I know the Sega Saturn version is held in very high regard, and that's Knight's Journey of Dreams. This was like $4 at GameStop. So I haven't played it myself, but I think you just owe it to yourself to pick up a game for $4 on the Wii. Because I can't imagine that it's a terrible game by any means. It looks like a lot of fun. Really charming graphics, it looks like, from the back here. And it looks like a really fun game. So I'm going to be really happy. I'm happy to finally own this, and I'm going to be excited to pop this in at some point. And the last game just looks so freaking bizarre and over the top. There's a version of this game on the Xbox 360, I believe, as well. And that is Oni Chanbara, I believe is how you pronounce that. Bikini Zombie Slayers. I mean, just that title alone is just like, I just hear voices saying, Rusty, grab me and play me right now. That just sounds so absurd and just so fun. Just crazy Japanese girls running around slaying zombies. I don't think you could ask for more in a video game. That just sounds like a lot of fun. So I'm really happy to own this game. I know Craig picked this up a while back, TV and Lust. And when he picked it up, you know, it kind of caught my eye. But I had kind of forgotten about it. And I got this for also $4 at GameStop. So really cool stuff here, guys. Like I said, if you don't think there are good games on the Wii, I don't know who you're getting your information from, but you are missing out. Because games like this, you don't come across every day. So Oni Chanbara, Bikini Zombie Slayers, I cannot wait to pop this game in. This just looks crazy. Alright guys, so that's everything I picked up in December, or at least a portion of it. You guys saw everything in my other previous videos. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know what you guys have been playing recently. I'm sure you guys got tons of goodies over this holiday season with all the sales going on. So let me know what you guys have been playing. Let me know what you've gotten recently. Let me know if you've played any of these games here. But thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned for more videos in the near future.